Hello everyone, in the last video I have discussed definite integral video part 1, some concepts up to point number 4 and solution of this question 2 questions. Okay, now I am going to discuss concepts plus remaining questions solution. Let's start question. Let's start concept number 5. If integral fx dx discontinuous at x equal to c, where c belongs to in the interval ab, then you can write ab fx dx a to c, just before c fx dx, because this function is discontinuous at c. Okay, so just before c, and this is just after c, that is c plus b fx dx. And concept c, note number 6, if this is more important for shortcut techniques, if integral a to b fx dx is 0, represents area is 0. Integral a to b fx dx is 0 means area is 0, you know. So, or integral a to a fx dx is 0 means a to a means no area will found. So, area automatically 0. Like this, if a curve, any curve, then from this is a, then a to a, that is this line, that is where the area, so automatically is 0, because definite integral always represent an area. So you can say integral a to b fx dx is 0 implies that positive area equals to negative area. This is more important remembering point. Okay, when integral a to b fx dx is 0, implies that positive area equals to negative area, like this. If this curve, if we go in this way, then like this here, and this is this. So this is x equals to a, and this is x equals to b. Okay, and this function is fx. So fx, this function go such that way, cut the on x axis, this is your x axis, this is your y equal to fx axis. So this is the cut where fx is 0. Fx is 0. So this area and this area are equal. This is positive area and this is negative area. Then two equals are area. So automatically this function go in this such that way, this point is 0. So when you can say the definite integrals represent solid algebraical sum of the areas. Algebraical sum means this area will be cancelled. So area will be 0. So this area same, and positive negative. That's it. Then you can say the area is 0. The area is 0 means this function, that is integrand function fx, will be passes through the point 0. Okay, that is, you can say integral a to b fx dx is a minus a is 0, remembering this point. Let's an example question. Next, point number 7. If integral a to b fx dx is 0, then there exist at least one point of fx lie between a and b. This is the note. So this is remembering point for short MCQ type question. Example number, integral 0 to 1 e power x square multiplied by x minus alpha dx is 0. Then option A, alpha is positive, option B, alpha is less than 1, and option C, 0 less than alpha less than 1, and D, alpha less than 0. Just I have discussed the note, since this area is 0, okay, and the function here e power x square common x minus alpha, so you cannot draw this graph. If you draw the graph, you can imagine, you cannot draw the graph, not possible for graph, then you can and imagine a graph like this way, as area, and this area, you assume the graph of this function, e power x square x minus alpha, its graph cannot possible easily, or mallo not possible, you cannot draw up this graph. So you can imagine a graph in this way, which is passing through the point where fx is 0. That is according to the theory just I have discussed, that this will be 0, so positive area is negative area, that is fx is 0. So here positive area is negative area, this area same, so fx is 0, so u power x minus alpha is 0. That is, you can say, and this point is 0, because 0 to 1, so this is 0 and this is x equal to 1, this line x equal to 1 and this is x equal to 0, because this integrand is 0 to 1 and area is 0, so that is, this function passes through the point in this way. So you can show this point lie between in 0 to 1, okay, because x minus alpha 0, so x equals to alpha, because e power x square cannot 0, so x equal to alpha, so this point is x equals to alpha, this point x equal to alpha, so alpha lie between 0 to 1, okay, alpha lie between 0 to 1, so this is the option, alpha between 0, lie between 0 to 1. Okay, let's another question. If 2a plus 3b plus 6c equals to 0, 2a plus 3b plus 6c is 0, then prove that fx equals to a square plus bx plus c must have at least one root in 0, 1. Okay. Or these questions can be arranged in this way. If fx equals to x square plus bx plus c must have at least one root in 0 to 1, then value of 2a plus 3b plus 6c equals to option A 1, option B 0, option C minus 1, and D is 2. Which is the correct option. Now, according to the question, 0, then prove that this is the must have at least one root 0, 1. That is, must have at least one root in 0, 1. So you can say 0 to 1, this is 0, and like this, this is your x equals to 1. X equals to 1. So function at least 0 to 1, that is function going in this way, which integration is 0 to 1, x square plus bx plus c dx is 0. Because this function going in such that way, which positive area and negative area are equal, that is this way. this way, that is this positive area and this negative area are equal. So where this is the point where fx is 0, here the function, this function is x square plus bx plus c. This point is 0 because area of this 0 means positive area and negative area is 0. So now you can say ax cube upon 3 bx square upon 2 plus cx equals to 0. A is constant, B, C constant, x square ka integration x cube by 3, x ka integration x square by 2, C multiplied by 1 ka integration x, okay. So, this will be 2, 3 ka LCM 6, so this will be 2A x cube, sorry, this will be 0 to 1, lower limit and upper limit 0 to 1, and this is a upon 3 1 cube minus 0 cube plus b upon 2 1 square minus 0 square, and this is 1 minus 0 and this is 0. So this is a upon 3 b upon 2 plus c 0. So now if we multiply, this will be 6a plus 3b plus 2b, sorry, 2a plus 6 3b plus 6 c is 0, that is 2a plus 3b plus 6c is 0. Okay, so 0 is the correct option, option B will be 0. Okay, now I am solve question number 3. In last video I have solved question 1 and 2, and question number 3 is, this question 3 is integral 0 to pi under root of 1 plus cos x upon 2. Integral 0 to pi under root of 1 plus cos x upon 2 dx. Okay. And this is integral 0 to pi under root of 1 plus cos x means 2 cos square x. 1 plus cos x means 2 cos square. This question is plus limit stage 1 plus cos 2x. Okay, this will be 1 plus cos 2x. So 1 plus cos 2x, then this is 1 plus cos 2 cos square x, and this is 2, and 2 to each cancel, and this will be, this will be integral 0 to pi mod of cos x dx, because under root of x square you know mod x. Okay, so this is, if we draw the graph of cos x, then there will be this. So this is 0 and pi, this is pi by 2 and this is pi. So in between 0 to pi, this is positive up to pi by 2, and before, after pi by 2 to pi is negative. So this in integral will be 0 to pi by 2 plus pi by 2 to pi. Pi by 2 to pi. Pi by 2 to pi is cos x value is negative. So when in modulus, under negative hai, so minus cos x dx, and modulus under positive hai, so cos x mod cos x as it is cos x. So this will be sin x, this will be sin x 0 to pi, and this is minus sin x pi by 2 pi, and this is sin pi minus 0, and this is sin pi minus sin pi by 2, and this is 0 minus 0 plus 1. So sorry, this is 0 to pi by 2, so this will be 0 to pi by 2 and pi by 2 pi. So this is 0 to pi by 2 and this is pi by 2, that is this will be minus 1 minus 0 plus 1, that is 2 unit square. So this is the answer, correct answer. If having options this question, then this will be correct option. Okay, in the last video, part 1, in part 1 I have solved the question number 2. Okay, in modulus function ln mod x, so when x is positive, then this is comes to minus 1 upon e to e log mod of log t dt. That is as well this question. Question number 4. Clearly see this question. This question number 2. This question number 2. Question number 2. If when reduce in this way, minus 1 by e to log mod t, that is question, this question, question number 4, 1 upon e to e mod of ln x dx, that is this question. So let's start, let's say question number 5, 1 by e to e mod of ln x upon x dx. Question number 5, 1 upon e to e mod of ln x on x dx. Here clearly observe that x belongs to in the interval 1 upon e to e. So obviously x is positive, and in modulus function when x is positive, then this is kuch bhi nahi hai. This is in denominator niche mein mod x upon mod x is as it is x, and this is ln x dx because x is positive, so 1 upon e to e, okay. And if we draw the graph of ln x, then this will be go in this way, and this is 1, because after 1 graph of ln x is increasing, and before 1 but after 0 graph of ln x is below, decreasing on below x axis. So 1 upon e to e, and this is e 2.7 something, this is e, and this is 1 upon 0.3, 1 upon e just 0.3, near about 0.3, 0.3, so this is 0.3, 1 upon e, okay. So this graph is 1 upon e to 1 plus 1 to 1 upon e dx, okay, because when 1 upon e, 1 by e to 1, the graph of this function is negative, and after 1 to e is negative. So in modulus function when negative, this will be more ln x minus ln x upon x, because after 1 and before 1 is negative, sorry, before 1 is negative, so this will be minus ln x upon x, and after 1 this is positive, so this is positive in modulus function, that is ln x as it is, okay. Now clear, in modulus function positive, then this is positive as it is, and negative negative, but in the interval before 1 graph of this function is negative, so ln x here negative, because below 1 and after 1 is positive, after 1, 1 to e, this is positive. And integral ln x upon x dx, its integration is ln x, its integration is ln x, and first function, take this is first function, and this is 1 upon x is second function. So integral 1 upon x is ln x minus ln x derivative 1 by x, and this is also ln x dx. So when it's left side, and this will be 2 ln x upon x is ln x whole square. So integration of this is ln x whole square by 2. So this will be minus ln x whole square by 2, 1 upon e to 1, plus ln x whole square by 2, 1 to e, and after simplification this will be minus ln 1 whole square 2 minus ln 1 upon e whole square upon 2, and this will be minus my plus ln e whole square upon 2 minus ln 1 whole square upon 2, and this will be ln 1 means 0, and this is minus minus plus, and ln 1 upon e means minus ln e whole square upon 2, and this is ln e minus 1, that is 1 by 2, and this is ln 0, and this is half plus half, and this is 1. So this is the correct answer or correct option. Okay, let's for solution of this question, please watch my next video. Okay, so have a good day and thanks for watching, and stay tuned with my channel Inspire Mathematics Classes.